Hey folks, it's Rich Mack here, and welcome back to a very belated leg number 56 of our Around the World journey. We are in... Where in the heck are we again? We are in Yaoundé in Cameroon. Hang on, I'm just watching this live traffic come in here. Ouch. Look at that, perfectly smooth landing. And we are headed to Berberati in the Central African Republic. We are heading way out there today, folks. Gonna be an interesting flight, and let's get down here. It's been a while, and I apologize, and I'll get into that in a minute. But let's get moving here. So yeah, those of you who watch, and I appreciate that you watch. It has been I gotta learn how to fly a plane again. It's really been that long and that bad. Parking brake, thank you. All right, let's get going here. Yeah, it's been a while. Real life really caught up to me, and kind of made things a mess as far as my schedule. Oh, are we crashing? What is that? Don't know what that was all about. Hope that doesn't happen again. Jesus. All right. See if I remember where I'm going here. This is where I want to be. I think it's been a week or over a week since I was able to get a video uploaded, and honestly, it's been longer than that since I've flown. Make sure there's no traffic coming in here. It'll clear down there. Gonna have a long flight today, folks. It's gonna be about a 300-mile flight. And that actually has been part of my problem. This is gonna be probably a 2.5-hour flight, and I've been trying to get some time where I can really do this. And yeah, all my whining aside, I just really haven't had any time to do it. Well, see, the traffic was coming in that way, but the wind... I was actually just going this way, following the traffic. Well, I'm gonna take off this way anyhow. We're gonna take off with the tailwind. That's the way it's gonna be. Let's go. Let's get out of here. Come on. A taxi on the right side of this runway here. I could taxi in the center of the runway, but why would I want to do that? That would make things too easy. Besides, I got to turn around up here. Another thing that I'll be happy to be getting rid of here is I think as we make this flight today, we're going to get away from the coast now. And I think the coast is where all these thunderstorms are kicking up. So I believe that we're going to leave these thunderstorms behind us. And nothing but thunderstorms for a while. Take off flaps. If I forgot anything here. Here we go. shade. Positive right gear up. Now I got a couple of cool additions here that you're not going to be able to see, but they're really helping me out. And I'll get into that in a minute. So go with the autopilot here. And flaps up. One thing I need to do. Alright, I need to... We'll climb to 5,000 feet. Because we're already at about 2,000 foot elevation. So let's do that. Lights here. Don't need our landing light or our taxi lights. We're gonna pull back on the throttle just a tad. We're 89% throttle right now. Go outside and take a gander around here. Did I clean the plane up? Looks like I did. Gear up. Flaps up. Alright. So now that we're up in the air. And we're going to have a ways to go. I'm going to start talking. So what happened was, well, like I said, my work schedule changed. Kind of, sort of. I got a great job. I'm not going to say where I work, but I got a great job. And one of the benefits of the job is I have really good hours. Well, my hours now got extended a little bit after the pandemic, and we're going back to working. We've always been working, but now we're going back to work really full blast. So I lost a lot of my opportunity there to make these flights. That, and we had a lot of stuff going on at home, just really meant that I really couldn't do this. I couldn't get even a couple hours in really to make these flights. So here I am now tonight doing it. And typically what happens is, you know, if I get a good day to make flights, to fly, I'll make like a, you know, 2-3 legs at a time. And I'll can those extra legs. So I'll wait a couple days and publish the next one. I'll wait a few days and publish the next one. I usually have a few flights built in. And I did. I had, I think, like 3 flights built in. And you know, I don't like publishing them like every day. I like to leave a couple days and space them out. So, you know, I did that and I ran out of flights. I ran out of flights and didn't have the time to get a new flight in. And it's been, I think, well over a week since I published. And I think it's been maybe 2 or 3 weeks since I've flown. It took me about 20 minutes, I think, to get the sim started up and the plane ready to go from cold and dark. Just because I hadn't flown in a while and couldn't remember what to do. So, I know what I forgot to do. Let's see if I can do that from here. Nope, can't do it. Alright. Let's go back in the aircraft here. Not allowing me to go into nav mode right now. Why is that happening? Alright, let's forget heading. Let's go in and... Oh, I'm in. That up for a GPS. Now we'll go into nav mode. Okay, now we're cooking with fire. So So even though I could not fly, that didn't stop me from getting a few toys. And hey, I gotta go back in again. Sorry about this. Just want to cut the throttle back. Something reasonable, especially for a little longer flight. So my two new toys are rather simple, but they're kind of cool. I went on, of all places, I went on Etsy. You know, I wouldn't think that Etsy's a place that I would do a lot of shopping, but I found out that there's some really cool accessories for the Honeycomb Bravo on Etsy. People make, I guess they do some 3D printing and make some, like I said, some pretty cool accessories. So what I got was a trim wheel that's ribbed, so it's easier to manipulate. The trim wheel that comes with a Honeycomb Bravo is like a commercial aircraft trim wheel. It's smooth. It's a smooth disc. So when you're trying to, spin it around by hand, there's nothing really to grab there. It's a little, not awkward, but it's just these ribs on here, it's easier to trim it up. So anyhow, that's that. And the other thing I got, which is really cool, I was able to get a DA62 throttle handles for my Honeycomb Bravo. So they look just here. I'm gonna go back to the aircraft again. They look just like the like these guys. They're little cylinders. They're black. Pretty cool. Very cool, actually. They got a great feel to them. They fit in the hand much better than the standard throttle handles that come with the Honeycomb Bravo. Not that there's anything wrong with those, but these are really better. Love them. So those are my two new toys, and that's about it right now. That's all I got. So now we're actually heading in a southerly direction to catch back up to the flight path. We're about 3 miles to go, then we're making a turn to the east. This flight's going to be generally to the east. I'm going to go back to my other new toy. And as you will be able to, there we go, back out. As you can see, we're heading across Cameroon, to the Central African Republic. So there we are, starting out near Yaoundé. And just really going easterly. A little tad northern component to it. The Berberati. We're really going inland now. Again, the weather in Berberati looked a little better. Berberati is going to be interesting because it is a very small airport. It is a dirt strip. There are no approach plates or anything really to it. It's just a total VFR. And about a 5,000-foot dirt strip. I'm really bad at spotting dirt strips in this game, too, so it's going to make things more interesting. See how many times I circle around and miss it. Another thing I'm afraid we might run into, and we'll find out. I don't know if there's like a lot of satellite imagery out here in some of these spots. We are, again, really heading to some remote areas. So we might end up with some AI-generated scenery down below us. I think we ran into a little bit of it in a few previous flights, and it looks kind of crappy. And I do believe that generally the terrain is generally flat below us, so not a lot of mountains or anything to worry about. try descending a little bit here, see if we get down below some of these clouds. I was at 5,000 feet, want to drop down to 4,000. Again, most of the terrain below us is around 2,000 feet, so that'll put us about 2,000 feet above AGL. Above AGL? The A is above. So far it looks good down there. So from here, it's almost a straight shot into Berberati. But a little over 200 miles. I think I have that right. I had 294 miles on the flight. Definitely haven't gone over 200 or over 94 miles, but just looking at my Garmin here. Few hills out there. It's not totally flat. I forgot I have a mouse. I can use as a pointer now. You know, some of this terrain, that stuff there, maybe some of this stuff down here. I don't know if that's like auto-generated. That may not be satellite. I don't know. Nice river that looks like it runs up over a hill and down. Love it. Yeah, look at that up ahead. I think that's something going on with the scenery up there. Like that line right there. Everything to the left looks totally different than the other stuff to the right. No. Whatever it is, what it is. Looks like we're already kind of leaving some of the more significant storms behind us. As soon as I say that, I get a shot of thunder. another thing that's been driving me crazy is this chair I got. And you can hear it, the creaky chair. I'm doing that on purpose now, though. Just drives me nuts. Well, I had enough of it, and I ordered a new chair. The good thing about it is Mrs. Mack's office is right next door to my room here, and she needs a new chair, so she graciously offered to take my chair, and I ordered myself a new chair, and I hope it does not creak like this one. Boy, do I hope it does not creak like this one. Is that water or a road? I can't figure out what that is. I guess water. Yeah, look at that line. I am so ADD today. Keep bouncing back and forth. So yeah, anyhow, I should hopefully in 2-3 days get my new chair. And if it's quieter, I'll be so happy. Plus, I don't think this chair is very comfortable. And again, I said it before, this is not a cheap chair I got. And kind of disappointing. And it's really hard to fly in it. It's kind of built like one of those racing chairs. And like back behind my shoulder blades, there's a piece of the chair that kind of wraps forward. Well, when I go to reach the throttle, my elbow hits that. So I've really got to contort myself to kind of reach the throttles here. Nice thing about the new chair I got is the armrests actually fold up. It doesn't have that nonsense behind me. It's just a flat back. And with the folding up arms in particular, here, you should listen to me creak around in this chair. With the arms folding up, I think I can slide the chair in a lot closer to the throttle. Because this chair right now, if I where I'm sitting, if I push the chair up any further, the arm actually hits the trim wheel. I can move the trim wheel around. I've done that before in flights. You may or may not have noticed. I think I may have actually said it a couple times. Well, anyhow, with that arm folding up in a new chair, won't be a problem. I like that. Be a small town or something there. It's hard to tell. I don't know what that red stuff is. Different. So a little Wikipedia knowledge of Berberati, our destination. It's the second largest city in the Central African Republic. Population of 15,000. That's 1-5. Unfortunately, I can report that Central African Republic is among one of the ten poorest countries in the world. That's all right, Central African Republic. You can do better. Better times are ahead. Anyhow, right now we're still in Cameroon. We won't get to the CAR for quite some time. Bigger town there. Kind of opens up from there's the thick, dense forest, kind of a river plain. Would that be an alluvial plain? Maybe? I don't know if that's the proper use of that term. Should have paid attention in geology. Kind of scary in this cloud, so I should have gone around it. That, I believe, is a road. Yep. in general. It looks like it's clearing up a little bit in front of us now. So it seems like we're leaving a lot of that behind us. I'm going to climb back up to, right now, 4,500 feet. Still a line of clouds in front of us there. Much better than what's behind us, though. Passing through 4,500 right now. We're going to climb up to 5,000. That was my original intended altitude. So we'll go up there. I don't think we're going to have too many issues with clouds. Maybe some, but... not a lot of vast... probably really jungle down there now. And now we're settling in at 5,000. I'm going to keep my yapper shut for a while, let you enjoy. So that's pretty much what I got for Berberati Airport. So we'll be running on... We'll be landing on runway 35. Hoping this clears up soon. A little more promising now. See the aircraft getting buffeted around in the middle of those clouds. Again, if this was real life, I'd probably be making way more of an effort to get around these things. Do is I'll climb up to 6,000 feet. I'll just climb up another 1,000 feet. That'll keep me above most of these clouds. And with the hope that soon this stuff will be breaking up anyhow. Then I'll descend back down. Minute I thought it looked promising that it was breaking up, and instead it looks like it's filling back in. passing through 5700 right now. So it would have been down in those clouds, but now I'm just above them. And in fact, look out there, that this might be the end of it. It does really look promising out there. Yeah, that's nice. Alright, so once we get past this one cloud here, me messing around with the heading, bear with me here. And we'll start descending. So I'm just using the autopilot. And all I'm doing is just making slight heading adjustments and just working my way around these clouds. And then once we're around them, I'll just go back to heading and it'll put me right back on the flight path. Sending down through 5400 right now. Some cool convection out there. And we're beginning to level out at 5,000 right now. Which again is about 3,000 feet AGL. And back to nav. Making a quick little left here and just catching up with flight path. We're not far off of it at all. And then turn them back on it. And it just kept us out of the soup. Just avoided that little bit of nonsense right there. Lots of blue skies. Lots of jungle down there. A few little roads. Now here we're, I think we're still over Cameroon. Berberati is on the border with Cameroon, so we won't really be in the Central African Republic until right before we land. As you can see, the path, it's when we're taking pretty much a straight shot, and we'll be in the CAR really right at the end. Look at that line of storms behind us now. Look at that. That's pretty impressive. That's pretty neat. I need a screenshot of that. There's the depth of field. I couldn't remember the depth of field. That may make kind of a cool screenshot. Vastness of Africa in front of us. By the way, my flight plan and the Garmin wasn't really measuring up to, or matching up with the actual distances. So right now I've got just under 20 miles to Kogan, my next waypoint. And from Kogan, it's a straight shot in into the airport. According to the Garmin flight plan, it says it'll be 103 nautical miles. Curious to see what it actually shows up on the on the display once I get there. I have to remember to look in 18 miles. right, 4 miles to Kogan. We'll see if it matches up with 103 miles to the airport. To go. Pretty close. 105 miles. I swear the last leg was way off. Way off. But anyhow, 105 miles to the airport. So we're getting there. Jinx myself, but if you've noticed, we have been pummeled with lots of thunder and lightning. Again, I'm really hoping we leave a lot of that nonsense behind us. We do have some more clouds coming up. That's what we left behind. Little town down there. It's like fog down there. Look, it's burning off right there. When we get about 25 miles from the airport, I'll make a little deviation from the flight path about, well, to the right. Put us in a position to approach the airport from the south. So we have about 60 miles to go until I make that turn. Sure what the white spots are, our little town there. These little villages are laid out along the road here. Another one there. Nothing really seems to extend too far off the road though. Another one there and there. Yeah, they're all strung out. There's a bigger town up there. stars, no SIDS for Berberati. However, there was also this vicinity chart. I'll open that up. No instrument approach procedure established for this airport. You can see really there shouldn't be any obstacles in the way. Airport elevation 1,929 feet. We have some objects that are a little higher, but in general, and approaching from the south, which we're going to be doing, there's really nothing there. So runway 35, 348 degrees, I gotta remember that. So I'll approach from the south once I have the runway or the airport at 348 degrees, got a bearing at 348 degrees, and I'll know I'm one line with the runway or pretty darn close to it. It never works out exact, but right, we're at 50 miles out from the airport. In 25 miles, we'll make that turn to the right. Appears that we may be running in a little more clouds, but it doesn't look like anything too bad. Take a look behind us and see what it was like back there. Yeah, everything's kind of pretty far behind us now, so tough to really see. Quite honestly, I don't know exactly where we are on the map, but being only 50 miles out from Berberati, we might now be over the Central African Republic. There's a bigger town there. It is pretty flat here. to make that turn in 10 miles. And again, I'll just do that all with the autopilot. I'll just go to heading mode. Right now my bearing is 8-4. I already have my heading bug set to 120. I'm all good to go there. Also, I'm going to want to descend down about 4,000 feet. That'll put me about 2,000 feet AGL. But I can still wait a little while for that. It feels good to have flown again. Miles to go. I have my flight display up in another monitor here. I think I said that before, so I'll just watch there for my bearings. Kind of call them out so you have an idea what's going on. We are just over 27 nautical miles out from the airport, so in 2 miles I'll be making that right turn. Let's turn. So the idea behind this maneuver again is to put us south of the runway at a bearing of 348 from the runway. At hopefully a little over 10 miles. Some hills over there. saying it's flat, but it's not flat flat. Still kind of closing in with the airport, but not at the same speed. Crawling in right now at 21 miles out. Bearings dropped to 77 degrees. As we get more south of the airport, the bearing's going to start to change faster. Really, the more we deviate from the flight plan, from the flight path. I don't want to close too much with the airport either, so I want to watch that. Right now we're at 19 miles out. Still at a bearing of 71 degrees. Turn a little more to the right. Again, just don't want to close into the airport that quickly. Clouds from the satellite. Miles out, bearing of 57 degrees. Again, I'm going in a more southerly direction now, so I'm closing in on the airport very slowly. In fact, there may be a point where I start pulling away from the airport. up, and now I'm actually pulling away from the airport a little bit. Just went from 16.6 miles to 16.7. I'll take the hint there and come here. Make a tad 5-degree turn to the left here. So sitting again at 16.7 nautical miles out. Bearing of 39 degrees, 38 degrees. My goal maiming for 348 degrees, 348. In a perfect world, I'd be 15 miles out. That'd be a nice way, nice setup there. 16.8 nautical miles. If I'm still pulling away, I'll make another turn to the left. And I went up to 16.9. Go left 5 degrees to 125. Still at 16.9 nautical miles from the airport, now to 17 miles, bearing of 30 degrees. Do another turn to the left at 5 degrees, so now we're at 120 degrees. Again, just kind of edging to the left. I'm going to find a nice sweet spot where I just close in a little bit. All the meanwhile, my bearing's now down to 27 degrees. We're getting there. Still kind of pulling away, so again, we'll make another little turn to 115 degrees. Bearing 25. Another thing I want to do is descend now. We'll descend down to 4,000 feet, which is about 2,000 feet AGL. Check and make sure my memory is still good here. Yep. Airport elevation is 1,860 feet. Still pulling away. Alright, well, we'll do a 10-degree turn to the left this time. Bearing now is 14 degrees. Okay, we're going to make another turn to the left now. We'll turn all the way to due east, 90 degrees. Because we've stretched it out to 17.4 miles. I'm closing in on my bearing here, 348, pretty quickly now. Descending down through 4,130 feet, so we're almost at 4,000 feet. Things are looking good. Probably help if I threw all my lights on here. Making a sharp turn to the left now. We're getting pretty close to that bearing. I'm more worried about that right now. I don't want to go past it. So we're at 3 degrees. We're at 359. We only have 11 degrees to go. I'm turning over to 20 degrees on my heading now. So we're going to start coming to the airport pretty quickly. I'm going to have to go inside here. Throttle won't respond if I don't go in. Start slowing the plane down. We are 15 miles out. I'm going to cheat and go back to the right here. By about 20 degrees. See if I can cut this bearing down here. Turn back to the left now. I have 3 degrees to go. So I'm going to turn all the way over to 348 now. I'm going to put it right on the runway bearing. That should get us right there. We are at 349. Leveling out in our turn. See if that worked out. Well, close. We're off by 1 degree. 1 degree, how about that? Go back to the right a little bit and see what that does. If I can bleed off that 1 degree. Pull back on throttle a tad. There we go, now we're at 348. We're going to turn back left to 348. 11 miles out. That spot right there is our runway. We're 9 miles out. Still on the runway heading. Things are looking nice. At about 5 miles out, I'll drop the flaps. Yeah, I think that's the runway there. Again, I'm so lousy at spotting the dirt runways. It's not our runway, we're gonna make it our runway, right? Plugged that in earlier, but got slight crosswind of 3 knots. left to right, no big deal. Take off flaps. My plane. Descend down in. Yep, that's the runway. So, it did put us off the line a little bit again. That never works out exactly right. But close enough that we can make the magic happen. Bleed off some speed here. A little fast. Trim it back up. Back up. Haven't landed in a while. Landing flaps. It's a little more. This ribbed trim wheel makes a big difference. Crosswind went up to 6 knots. It's been a while. I forgot gear. That would have been really bad. And I don't know if there's really anywhere to... It's just... This is a street. I don't want to go up to a road. I'll just stop right here. I don't think I'm having any problem with anybody else coming in here right now. Through my parking brake line. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, maybe I could have gone up a little further. Oops. Or is that a road? I can't quite tell what's going on there. Town, I think, town is actually up there. Berberati. All right, folks. That was leg number 56. Why do I keep doing that? Leg number 56 of our Around the World journey. We are in Berberati in the Central African Republic. Wow. So far from home. Look at that fog. That's kind of cool. At least we're not inundated with thunderstorms anymore. All right, good stuff. Hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you back for the next one. Thanks, folks.